Hello friends, today I'll be preparing prawn gyros. This is an excellent side dish for biryani, rice rasam or rotis, or you can just serve it with just plain bread. It's an excellent side dish, or you can call it as a starter. It's wonderful. Now let's look into the ingredients and method and get started. First of all, what I've done is I've taken 4 Kashmiri or Bedge chilies and 4 Guntur chilies. Adjust the heat as per your taste. We are going to add chili powder as well. What I've done is, I've taken the chilies, washed it thoroughly and soaked it in warm water overnight. Now we are going to use only the chilies and discard the water. We do not want the water because it's going to be pungent and really spicy. In a fry pan, I'm going to go ahead and toast some spices in order to prepare the masala paste. So I'm going to add peppercorns, cumin, mustard seeds and fenugreek seeds. I'm going to toast this on a very low flame. Once the spices starts to splutter, just keep tossing it. Do not keep it on high flame. Once the spices stop spluttering, remove it from the flame and add it to a mixer jar immediately. This will take about hardly a minute's time. I'm going to grind the spices to a powder format. Now to the spices, I'm going to add 1 whole garlic which is peeled and washed thoroughly. Along with the red chilies and a splash of water, I'm going to grind it into a smooth paste. Now in about 1/4 cup of warm water, I'm going to add 1 small amla sized tamarind and soak this for about 5 minutes. After 5 minutes, I'm just going to squeeze the tamarind and extract the pulp. We're going to reserve the tamarind pulp in a bowl and we're going to use about 2 to 3 tablespoons of the tamarind pulp. Now let's marinate the prawns. I've taken about 1/2 kilo of prawns, deveined it, shelled it, washed it thoroughly and drained the excess moisture out. Now to the prawns, I'm going to add about 1/4 cup of fresh yogurt. Make sure the yogurt is not too sour. I'm going to add 1/2 lime, juice of 1/2 lime, 1 tablespoon of turmeric powder and 1 tablespoon of chili powder. Just a bit of salt just to marinate the prawns. I'm going to give this a good mix and marinate the prawns for 5 minutes on the kitchen counter itself. After 5 minutes, I'm going to go ahead and heat a pan with 2 tablespoons of ghee. Add 1/4 teaspoon of asafoetida. Allow the asafoetida to splutter a bit. Now I'm just going to transfer the marinated prawns and I'm not going to waste any of that marinade. I'm going to cook the prawns only for a minute's time so that it releases its juices and the marinade gets cooked fast. After a minute's time, I'm just going to remove the prawns and reserve it because we need to cook the prawns only for 5 minutes. The prawns need to cook in the masala. In 1 minute's time, you can see how much moisture the prawns has released. So we are going to cook the marinade and the masala paste together and reserve the prawns for later, because we need to cook the prawns later in the masala. I'm going to cook this marinade and the masala for 5 minutes time. Now I'm going to transfer the masala paste to the marinade. I'm not going to waste any of that masala. I'm going to wash the mixie down with 1/4 cup of water and add the water to the masala paste. This will help the masala to cook further. I'm going to give this a good stir and cook the masala further on low to medium flame. Once the masala has reduced and you can see the ghee surfacing to the sides of the pan, at that point you can add the prawns. Now you can see the ghee surfacing to the sides of the pan. At this point we're going to add the prawns. Now we're going to adjust the salt as per taste. Curds is too sour, then you need to adjust the tamarind content. I've added about 2 tablespoons of the tamarind pulp. I'm going to give this a good stir. At this point you can see the masala paste coating the prawns. In about 3 to 4 minutes time, you can see the masala paste has coated the prawns well. Now we need to roast this further. We'll add an extra 2 tablespoons of ghee, which will give good flavor and it will roast the prawns thoroughly. This is the key and the magic ingredient that they do in ghee roast. They add the 2 tablespoons of ghee at the end while they are roasting. The recipe in detail is posted on my blog. Blog link will be posted in the about bar below this video. The same video is translated and posted on my Tamil channel as well. You can also follow me on my social networks for regular updates. All the links will be posted in the about bar or the description box below this video. Now we are going to roast the prawns further. Now this is about 4.5 minutes. Now in 5 minutes time you can see the prawns, the masala has coated well and the ghee is separating from the prawns, and at this point the prawns are roasted and it's done. You can serve it as a starter or as a side dish for any roti, biryani, ghee rice, you name it, you can serve it for anything. This is an excellent dinner or a lunch item. If you're hosting lunch parties or dinner parties, this is an excellent side dish. People will definitely appreciate this. Now you can go ahead and serve it with some lime wedges and onion rings. Serve this hot. Do try this recipe. If you like this recipe, do give this recipe a thumbs up and share it with your friends and family. Subscribe to my channel. I'll be seeing you soon with the next recipe video. Until next time, thanks for watching. Bye bye.